Hi creators, welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica and I have a great tutorial for you, especially if you are a 3D modeler. In this tutorial, we are gonna go over how to create mesh using curves. It's a jam-packed tutorial, so let's go ahead and get started. If you are new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, and Substance Painter. If that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in learning how to make mesh using curves. All right, so here's my Maya scene. And as you can see, it's just a typical lamp. And let's say I wanted to add some decor around this object. So you could take a object and extrude, but that's pretty complicated, but I'm gonna show you a trick. The first thing we're gonna do is select the lamp and then we're gonna hit the magnet. That's gonna make this object live. That means things are gonna attach to it like a magnet, which makes sense with this graphic up here at the top. So we need a curve. We're gonna go to create curve tools, EP curve tool, and then this is where we create our decoration. So for example, maybe I just click here and then I just kind of go around and you can see that it's attaching itself to the lamp. Now it's a little bit hard to see, but let's go ahead and center this pivot and then we're going to move this up a little bit. And here we can actually go through and make some alterations. So if I'm not happy with the way this is looking, I can go ahead and attach it. Now the live is still on, so it's really important to have that active so that the curves attach to it. Once you're ready, go ahead and go to object mode, turn off make live, and we now have this really nice curve that wraps around the model. Next, I'm going to show you the tool, which is a really fast way of creating mesh using a curve. So select your curve, and I'm gonna go to create sweet mesh. And you'll notice that it automatically creates this mesh, which is awesome. If I select it, you can see the subdivisions. We can give it more sides, so if you want it to be smoother, you can. You can increase and decrease the scale, so if you want it a little bit more decorative, you can. If you're interested, you can rotate it. You can also twist it to give it some interesting looks, and you can also taper it. So if you want it to make it look more like a plant or a little bit more organic, you can as well. Other cool things include that you can change the shape. Right now it's a polygon. You can change it into a rectangle. So now it has like beveled edges and it also has a few more options to play around with, such as the width, such as the height, the corner radius, which is basically the bevel, corner segment, so you can increase and decrease the bevel, and then you've got corner depths. Now I do like to add a cap because you'll notice that it's like a cave. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn off a cap. And again, you can play with the scale and all sorts of things. Other options include line, arc, wave, and custom. But I'm gonna stick with rectangle because I think that one looks nice. There are some other options like just distribution, which gives you an interesting effect, and also alignment, which right now it's just fine where it's at, but we can move it around. There's a little bit more of a control in the taper, and I highly encourage you to go ahead and play with those, but that is how quickly you can create mesh using a curve. You can also press the number 3 and you can get a nice looking mesh as well. So fairly quickly, you can create mesh using a curve. And of course you can push it in if you want to or make your changes. All right, that's the first one. Then I'm gonna go ahead and hide this. Control H, Control H. Let's hide this as well, Control H, and let's bring up the teacup. The other method that you can create mesh using a curve is by extruding. So I'm gonna go to my front view and I want to make a little handle here. So again, I'm gonna use a create curve tools, EP curve tool, and I'm just gonna make a little curve. Again, I'm on the front view so that I can have control over where it's gonna be placed. And it doesn't give me something random. And let's say I wanted to curve like this. It's not perfect, maybe something like that. All right, next is what face do I want this to extrude with? So I actually wanna move this a little bit over here. I'm gonna bring this a little closer so you guys can see the effect. Now, if I just grab this face and I shift select the curve and I extrude, you're gonna see that it gives me a really big piece of mesh. So what you wanna do is, you see this little window, increase your divisions, right? But you'll notice that this is a huge cup now, like it's a huge handle. If I press the number 3, it looks all right, but it's a little thick. So I'm gonna go ahead and undo, and make some alterations to my mesh. So for example, I'm going to extrude. Let me press the number one so you guys can see. I'm going to make it smaller and also make it a little flatter. Something like that. And then try again. Select the face, shift select the curve, control E, which is extrude, or you can press the button up here, which is extrude, control E. Again, increase the divisions. There we go. And what's fun about this is that we can make some changes such as the thickness. The big one though is actually over here in the right where you can also taper it. So if you want it to be thinner at the edge, you can. You can also twist it. Not sure why you would want to, but here you go. You can twist it if you like. And you can also give yourself more division. So right now it feels like that's the max. You can always type it in. So for example, I can increase my divisions to 40, and there we go. So very quickly, I can get some really nice looking mesh for my cup. It's over here. Let me make some adjustments here. And there you go, very quickly. You can get some really nice and pretty complicated mesh. Imagine trying to extrude all this. No, thank you, this is way easier. And finally, the one that I find really fun. Actually, I find all three really interesting, but the other trick I wanted to show you is that you can attach a previously made geometry onto a curve. This is found under rigging. If I go to this pull-down menu and go to rigging, I want to select my mesh, shift select the curve, then I'm going to go to the form and go to curve wrap. And you'll notice that it wraps around my object. There's a few things that is really fun about this. One, if you see the curve wrap, you're going to see that it has an envelope, which is the one that tells how closely should you follow the curve. The other one is the offset. If you select it and drag it, you'll see that my helix follows along with it. So if you wanted to, you can actually animate this thing to follow a curve, which I think it's really interesting. The other thing I wanted to show you is that you still have control over your mesh, especially if you have kept your history for these helix. So for example, this is the curve wrap, and below that is the polyhelix. And what I can do is increase my height, and then I can also increase my coils. So if you guys need to use something like rope, or if you needed to make pipes, or in this case, you can make a phone cord, wrap around here, increase your coils. You can see that it won't go any further, so I'm gonna type in 50, maybe 60. And you can see that it wraps around it really well. And there's more, but wait, there's more. I'm going to right click and go to, oh, those are vertices. Let me get closer. Right click, control vertex. What's great about this is still under control. So I can actually move this around and the model follows along. So if you want to, you can even animate the control points and get this thing to move around as well. So this is kind of like a fun little thing you can do. You can select multiple curves and move it around. And you can see that it gives you like a pretty cool looking effect. So those are the three tips where you can get mesh out of curves in Autodesk Maya. All right, what did you think? Did you like it? If you did, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you are interested in this content and that you want to see more. Please share my videos. If you feel an artist like you can use this to help accelerate their pipeline, then please share my videos. That would make me really, really happy, and also would make the YouTube gods happy. The more people subscribe, like, and share my videos, the more I can provide this content to artists just like you. Also, don't forget to take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you will find free content such as 3D models, resources, ebooks, and so much more. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time. And one last note, do you recognize the background that I chose for my recording? Let me know in the comments, and you might get a little digital medal for the right answer.